Dear students, today we discuss differential equations in mathematics. In Mathematica, we can find derivative of a function using the command capital D. D is for derivative, D of syntax is D followed by square bracket. Then write the function, any function say tan x, then with respect to x, so put comma and write x. Okay, derivative is sec of x square. Okay. We can have partial derivative if our function contains two or more variables. Okay. So if I am writing d of say x square into y plus x into z, then this will provide derivative with respect to x is 2xy plus z. Okay, so this is partial derivative. Okay, so capital D is used to find derivative or partial derivative. We can have second order derivative. Here we need to use a list x comma 2. Okay. This will provide second order derivative. Okay. And so on. Now let us move to differential equations. Okay. Syntax is dsolve. So Mathematica function dsolve is helpful in finding exact solutions of differential equations. Okay. So whenever possible, this command will provide exact solution of differential equation or system of differential equations. So let us consider simple differential equation. Say y double dash of x plus 4 times y dash of x minus 2 y of x equal to, okay? And we should write equal to, okay? And then right hand side. Here y is dependent variable and x is independent variable. Okay, so let us consider non-homogeneous equation. It is linear non-homogeneous equation with constant coefficients. Okay, so this is first entry equation. Then put comma and write down name of dependent variable. Here it is y. And then put comma and insert the name of independent variable. Okay. Here it is x and run. Okay. This is required solution. It is given like y arrow function in braces. It is x. That means this is function of x and it is given by 1 half minus 2 minus x plus e raised to minus 2 minus square root 6 x c1. C1 and c2 are there. C1 and c2 are arbitrary constants. Okay, this is second order ODE, so it will have two arbitrary constants if we are not providing initial conditions. Okay, so this is the required answer. Yes, instead of y here, if we put y of x, then this function square bracket will be removed. Okay, so directly we will get y of x arrow, that means this y of x is 1 half minus 2 minus x, etc. Okay, so it is better to write dependent variable as y of x instead of simply y. Okay, let us give some initial values. Okay, so how to provide initial values? So if we want to insert initial values, we need a list. Okay, so in that list we need to put our differential equation and corresponding initial conditions. Say y of 0 equal to 1 and another initial condition y dash 0 equal to say minus 1. Okay, so this is the required answer and this is free from arbitrary constants. Okay, so this was linear. We can have non-linear equations. Let us try some non-linear equation. Okay, in general non-linear equations are solved numerically. Okay, in some cases we can have exact solution. Okay, otherwise we need numerical solution. Okay, let us consider a simple non-linear equation. So we consider first order ODE. So instead of y, let me write y of x square. Okay, let us see whether we can have some exact solution. Okay, so Mathematica is providing exact solution in terms of Bessel functions. Okay, so these are special functions involved in this solution. Okay, so again C1 arbitrary constant is there. We can also have equation with variable coefficients. Okay, so we try this example with variable coefficients. Okay, let us check whether we are getting some answer. Okay, so here instead of 4, let us put 4 times x. Okay, there is blue color, so either put space or star. Okay, we are multiplying x and y dash. Okay, so it is better to use star. Okay, now it is okay. Y is in green color. Okay, okay, so this is the solution of this linear non-homogeneous problem with variable coefficients. Answer is given in terms of so many special functions like hypergeometric function, gamma function, Hermite function, and so on. Okay, of course we can plot these solutions. Okay, so how to plot these solutions? Let us use the command plot. Okay, so I am copying and pasting this function and trying to sketch. Okay, plot. Okay, so I need to remove this y of x. Okay, so plot. I need to remove these braces also. This is my big expression. Well, let me reduce the font size. Yeah, fine. So here we take X from maybe 0.124. Let us try. Okay. Okay. Nothing is given by Mathematica. Maybe some issues in this range. Okay, we may need to change this range. Okay, so what we do, let me check. What happens if we put these values of x? Okay, it is not small expression. Still, it is not providing. Okay, the answer there is K1 and K2 involved here. We may need to find these particular values. But anyway, we can plot all other solutions. Okay, so let us try other solutions. Maybe we can try this one. Let us scale this for x between say 0 to 10. Okay, so this is solution come. Okay, we can try other solutions also, especially which are involving such special functions. Okay. Next, we try system of differential equations. Okay, so we discussed differential equation and initial value problem. Okay, now let us see system of differential equations. These are okay, now for system of equations, again we need list. Okay, so let me insert a list. So here we take dependent variables as x, y, and z. Independent variable will be t. So x dash of t equal to say 2x of t minus 3y of t plus z of t. Second equation is y dash t equal to minus x of t plus 4y of t plus 2z of t. And third equation is z dash equal to say minus 3x minus y plus z. Okay, so all these are equations. Okay, this is system of differential equations. Then we can have initial values, say x of 0 equal to 0.2, y of 0 is 3, and z of 0 is say minus 1. Okay, so this is first entry. Second entry is list of dependent variables x of t, y of t, and z of t. And third thing is independent variable t. Okay. Okay, so this is solution, but in terms of roots of characteristic polynomial. Okay, so in fact here we get a matrix on right hand side, and this is nothing but characteristic polynomial of coefficient matrix. Okay, it is in degree 3. Okay, so let us consider, let me check whether it is possible to find numerical solution. Okay, fine. So instead of exact coefficients, I provided approximate. I mean, instead of 3, I'm putting 3.0. That's all. Okay. So answer is like this. Let me increase the font. Okay. Answer is x is given by this minus 1.299. Okay. Plus 3 into 10 raised to minus 18 means it is approximately 0. Okay, so minus 1.3 we can say. Okay, minus 1.3. Here it is 1 e raised to 5.4t. Okay, and similarly. Okay, so complex things are almost 0. Okay, so this is required answer. This is x of t, then there is y of t, and this is z of t. Okay. Similarly, we can sketch these solutions if we have real solutions. Okay. So this is system of ordinary differential equations. Now we consider numerical solutions of differential equations. Okay. In most of the cases, in natural models, we get non-linear ordinary differential equations, and which are not easy to solve. Okay, so we need numerical methods such as Runge-Kutta method. Okay, so Mathematica command ndsolve uses Runge-Kutta methods and provides us numerical solution. Okay, so let us see. So for solving nonlinear equations, the syntax is ndsolve N means numerical, D means differential equation solve. Okay, so numerical solutions of differential equations. Okay, but remember that you need to give some name to this command if you want to sketch the solution. Okay, because solution will be provided in terms of interpolation function. Okay, so let us give any name. Okay, say solution equal. Okay, so this will be a reference for sketching the solutions. Okay, we need to refer to this name. Okay, it can be smaller. Instead of solution, we may consider SOL. Okay, that will be fine. Or simply a single letter S. Okay, so here we need to put equations. This thing is same as DSOL. Okay. Again, remember that we need to provide all the initial conditions. Okay, so it is not like DSOL. Okay, so in DSOL, if we don't provide initial conditions, it will give answer in terms of arbitrary constants C1, C2, etc. Okay, so here it is not possible. We have to provide all the initial conditions. All the coefficients should be known. All the functions should be known. Okay. So here, in the first list, I am inserting y dash of x equal to, say, y of x into sine of y of x. Okay, so this is non-linear equation in y, non-linear ODE in y. Okay, so this is equation, then initial condition y of 0, say 1. Okay, whatever we want, we can take. Okay, so equation, initial condition. Second thing is y or y of x, doesn't matter, dependent variable. And third thing is independent variable with range. Okay, so third term should be a list containing name of independent variable, its starting value and highest value, okay, range of solution. Okay, so let us take 0 to 30, doesn't matter. Okay, now run. Okay, so answer is given in terms of interpolating function. Okay, so if you want to visualize this solution, you need to plot. Okay, but remember again, while plotting, you need to refer to this SOL thing. Okay, now it is black color. So plot y of x /dot means replace all. In Mathematica, /dot means replace all. Okay, we are asking Mathematica to plot y of x, but replace all from SOL. That means take this y of x from the command SOL. Okay, then we are writing x from 0 to 30. Okay, and run. Okay, so this is solution curve. Okay, so this is solution of y dash equal to y into sine y, y of 0 equal to 1. You can try different nonlinear equations. Now, next example is of system of nonlinear differential equations. Okay, let me call now S, or maybe I will call S1 equal to, and this all. Now I am inserting system of equations. First equation in this system is x dot means derivative. Okay, here we are taking x dash, t is independent variable, equal to minus 10 x plus 10 y This is first equation. Second equation is y dash of t equal to 28x plus y plus sorry, it should be minus y and minus xz, x of t into z of t. Okay, this is second equation. Third equation is z dash equal to minus z by 3 z minus 8 by 3 z plus xy. Okay, these are three equations. Now initial conditions, x of 0 equal to 10, y of 0 equal to 0, and z of 0 equal to again 10. Okay, then here we have three dependent variables, so we need a list. Okay, unlike in previous case, here in previous case we had only one dependent variable. Okay, here we have three, so we are using list x, y, z. Okay, and then t, independent variable, range say 0 to 60. Okay, we may change as per our requirement. Okay, so here we are getting numerical solution. Let us sketch this solution. So plot we may sketch all these x, y, and z at once. Okay, say x of t slash dot s1. Okay, we are referring to s1. Y of t slash dot s1 and z of t slash dot s1. All the three in a single window. T is from 0 to 60. Okay, so it is difficult to recognize these three things. Okay, we may assign different colors, say plot style. Plot style, we assign three colors, say black, red, blue. Okay, red and blue are visible, black is not visible. Let us sketch, black means first x, let us sketch x separately. We see what is happening to x. Maybe x is overlapping with some other variable. Yes, so this is x. It is overlapping with it is overlapping with y. Here it is shown by red color. Okay. Okay, if we zoom this figure, then we can recognize that x and z are very close to each other. Their initial condition is also same. Okay, we may take different initial conditions so that we can recognize. Okay, but here it is possible to see that these two are different curves, in fact. Okay, so let me change this initial condition. So maybe we can have different figure. Not at, but anyway. So this is solution. This is very famous Lorentz system arising in metrology. Okay, so this is first known chaotic dynamical system. Okay, so this system is having history. You can search Google for this Lorentz system. First equation is linear. Second equation contains only one product nonlinearity, xz, and similarly third also x multiplied by y. Okay. If you sketch these three variables as a parametric plot, then the structure is a chaotic attractor. It looks like butterfly. Okay, so it is also called as butterfly diagram. Let us sketch in 3D or 2D maybe. So parametric plot. Let us sketch x and y. Parametric plot, x of t slash dot s1 and y of t, replace all, slash dot means replace all, s1. Okay, now t is between 0 and 60. Okay, maybe we need to put this replace all outside this bracket. Let us see. Yes, okay. So while using parametric plot, we need to put this slide dot s1 outside this list. Okay, not for each term. And when we are using plot, then we need here slide dot s1 for each term. Okay, so we are taking x, y, z from this s1 thing. Okay, so this is having two lobes. Okay, so like butterfly. Now let us sketch this in 3D. Okay, come on, this parametric plot 3D. Then we are using x, y, and z also. Okay, so this is 3D figure which we can visualize from any side using mouse. Just drag, okay? Click and drag. Okay, now let us move to important task, that is solving delay differential equations using Mathematica. Again, as we already have discussed, even if we have linear delay differential equation, we need not have exact solution. Okay, so most of the times we need to use numerical solutions of delay differential equations. So let us see how we can solve delay differential equations using ndsolve command. Okay. So there is slight change in the command. So let us consider first example. Again, we are using ndsolve. So first entry is delay differential equation. Here we consider second order delay differential equation. X double dash of t plus x of t minus 1. Okay, so this is delay term, x of t minus r. R is 1 in this case, equal to 0. Okay, we need some initial conditions. Okay, so we are putting this in a list. Okay. So first we consider initial condition. Okay, so maybe instead of second order, let us take first order so that we have only one condition. We provide initial condition in term, instead of initial condition, we have initial data. Okay, so let us consider initial data as t square. Okay, 5t is t square. So this is important step. Okay, so how to provide such initial condition? X of t is t square for t less than or equal to 0. Okay, so it is like this. X of t, remember this syntax, slash semicolon t less equal 0. How to put less equal? Less than and equal to both. Okay, then it will automatically take less equal. Okay, 0. Okay, so x of t oblique semicolon t less equal 0, then equal to here we are using t square. Okay, and again x dependent variable and independent variable t, we should provide range. Okay, say 0 to 10. Let us check whether we can find solution. Since we are using ndSol, we need to give some name, say s2 equal. Okay, so we are getting the answer. Let us sketch this answer. Plot x of t slash dot s2 t from 0 to 10. Okay, so this is our solution. Okay, we may take larger interval, say 100. Okay, so it is converging. Oh, sir, here I should put. Okay, it is converging to 0. Here, this range is not clear. So we may use plot range all. There are different options in plot. Okay, so plot range all. Now you can see that there are oscillations and later on it gets settled. Okay. Like this. Okay, so damped oscillations. Let us solve few more delay differential equations. Now we take S3. Our next question is x dot of t equal to sine of t minus 20. Sine, it is nonlinear. Now, first example was linear. Now we consider nonlinear delay differential equation. X dot of t equal to sine of x of t minus 20. This 20 is delay. Initial data is taken to be constant. You may take any other. Okay, of course, you can take different examples or you can modify these examples and practice. Okay, so it is very important to practice all these things. Okay, so I'm taking 0.001. okay, we may take any other thing. Okay, so let us see. Okay, let us plot this data. Now we have S3. Okay, so this is solution. Okay, if we change initial condition, then we get different solution. Okay, and now we consider a more complicated delay differential equation. we call this as S4. Equation is x dash equal to 2 times x of t minus r. Say here we take r to be say 0.8. Okay, we might change this value divided by 1 plus x of t minus r. Here it is pointed raised to 10. Okay, and initial data is 0.5. Okay, constant data. Let us see. Okay, we may say delay and sketch again. Okay, so this is solution curve. Let us change this delay and observe what happens. Okay, so instead of 0.8, maybe I will take 2 here also 2. Let us see. Okay, very similar behavior. Just take small delay, 0.2. Okay, now solution is smooth. Okay, so earlier as we increase the delay, solution is non-smooth. I mean, there was one sharp corner. Okay. Okay, so for larger values, we have such sharp corner. Okay. For ODE case, we usually get smooth solutions. Okay. So in delay differential equations, we may have such non-smooth solutions. Okay. So fine, thank you. Next time we discuss some more important things in mathematics. Thank you.